dear colleagues from the diplomatic corps, distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for accepting the invitation and coming to the Embassy of Ukraine for our today's important event. I am pleased to open this important conference and discussion entitled Lessons of Chernobyl, 25 years after. 25th anniversary is a unique opportunity to reflect on the events at the Chernobyl power plant on that calm April night in 1986. We have to think how finally mitigate the consequences of this major disaster and how to prevent such catastrophes from happening in the future. The recent tragic events in Japan, earthquake, tsunami, and then destruction of nuclear power units at Fukushima call for redoubled efforts in nuclear safety. Ukraine shares the pain of Fukushima, and because of Chernobyl, we feel this pain as no one in the world. We offered our help and humanitarian assistance from the very first moments of the disaster in Japan. I am convinced that all of you have been following the Kyiv summit on safe and innovative use of nuclear energy, Pledging Conference for Chernobyl Projects, and the International Conference 25 years after Chernobyl disaster, Securing the Future. On behalf of Ukraine, I would like to express my deep gratitude to all nations participated in these important events for their support of the initiative of Mr. Viktor Yanukovych, the President of Ukraine. The Donor Conference for Chernobyl-related projects was able to secure an unprecedented amount of 550 million euro, more than $700 million, to complete works in Chernobyl. And some more pledges are on their way to reach the goal of 750 million euro. The President of Ukraine announced that with necessary funds, the works at Chernobyl site will be completed by the year 2015. This will make our world safer and more secure place to live. I want to thank the United States government, which demonstrated its leadership in financing shelter fund and nuclear safety account. The United States already provided more than $240 million and recently pledged new funding of $123 million. We praise the active role of the President Obama in working side by side with his Ukrainian colleague to get necessary financing for the Chernobyl project. As President Obama pointed out in the recent statement, and I quote, "Nearly two decades of cooperation between Ukraine and the United States has made a lasting contribution to nuclear safety in the region and throughout the world." Chernobyl remains a significant financial burden for Ukraine's budget. Since collapse of the Soviet Union in 1991, Ukraine alone invested more than $15 billion to combat the consequences of the world's worst man-made nuclear disaster. Today's conference opens the Chernobyl Week in Washington, and we, as we call it, at the Embassy. Allow me, on behalf of the Embassy, to thank all of our partners, Global Green USA, and Physicians for Social Responsibility for making this happen and for their tireless efforts in sharing the message about Chernobyl. The future of mankind without nuclear energy is hardly possible. And at this conference, we will be able not only to take stock from the lessons of the past, but seek some answers for the future of safe and effective nuclear energy. I wish you a very productive discussion, and let me assure you that the embassy would always welcome friends of Ukraine on this and many other occasions. Thank you very much for your attention, and expressing my deep gratitude to Mr. Paul Volcker for his valuable efforts in organizing this conference. Let me give him the floor for his statement. Thank you.